for our first feature focus segment, I have an old friend, Dan Ray. Dan, how are you today?
I'm doing great, Stephen. How are you?
Good. Dan is an ex-Microsoft employee and has now become a huge impact. Not that he wasn't before on the community, but even more so. You do LinkedIn demos, YouTube. You got a ton of great stuff going on. And today we had chatted and you are going to talk about...
I'm going to talk about teams and dynamic groups in Microsoft 365.
So why is this important? Why is knowing dynamic groups, something that's kind of on the SharePoint side of the house, so important for teams?
Yeah, so the reason that it's so important is that it allows an administrator to define a Microsoft 365 group that auto-populates and removes people as the settings change that the group is based on.
All right. So we're hacking it from the back end. I love it. Yes. So let's take a look at your demo.
Excellent. So, Stephen, we talked about having rare superheroes as part of our environment. And so here I have M heroes, and you can see the membership type is assigned in my tenant. And the members and the owner at this point are just me. What I'm going to do is add one of our underrated superheroes, Bob, agent of Hydra, as a owner. And then we're going to add a couple other people, Zorn with an X. And I gave Zorn the last name Korn. And Zorn with a Z. And they must be related somehow because they both have the same last name. And this is typically how a team gets built. You either add them to the Microsoft 365 group behind the team, or you add them to the team itself from Microsoft Teams. So we'll do a refresh here, and we'll take a look at our M heroes, rare superhero names, and we'll go in and we'll change, just waiting for the update here. And when we go back to manage team, we'll see immediately that Bob, agent of Hydra, has been added as an owner. And as soon as the synchronization happens, we'll see the members and guests of Zorn and Zorn Korn added to the members. However, this requires an administrator or a team owner or somebody to go in and manage the group as heroes come and go. What I can do under the properties of the Microsoft 365 group is instead of assigned, I can choose dynamic user. And what dynamic user allows me to do is come up with a rule that is used in a query to populate or remove people from the actual group and thus the Microsoft team. So the dynamic query is powerful because I can use things like department, I can use location, geography, or other things in my dynamic rule membership. So the first thing I can do is look at the different properties. I could go with city. I can add complexity, look for people that are in a particular state and a particular department. In this case, we're just going to look for the department. We're going to do equals, but I could just as easily do contains if I want to pick up anything with heroes in the name of the department. And in this case, we're going to add the value of rare superheroes. And by adding that to the expression, now if I save that and I save this, everybody that's been put into that rare superheroes group becomes part of the team automatically. And the team actually manages its membership and its ownership automatically based on these settings. This is super powerful for a team's administrator because it's the least amount of effort to keep everybody that's in a particular department or a particular role in your company associated with the appropriate teams. There is no overhead beyond this. So we can see here all of the different usernames that I have. We can see that I have a user that I'm going in to change and make sure they're under the correct department. This is what fills in when you have the rare superheroes. So we've just added Zorn Korn, and we've got Zorn with a Z. And we're going to add that property to make it a Department of Rare Superheroes. And then once all of this updates, what happens in Teams and the group behind it is everything would be changed to, and we can see already, this team has membership settings that prevent you from adding or removing members. The reason for that, that you can't add or remove, is because we've already moved Zorn and Zorn into this group and thus the team. So instead of the way that we managed it before, where we just added people here as an administrator or owner of the group, we can now do this through the dynamic group and the membership query that gets defined here within Microsoft 365 groups. So I could add additional information to that or leave it as just the one variable.
Dan, that's great. It's, you know, really nice to see a shortcut that certainly makes it easier to do it. Could we also do this with like Azure AD groups? If I could say, hey, everybody in sales and everybody in marketing, and as people come and go from the company or vendors come and go, they're automatically added and removed?
Yeah, these are Azure AD groups. They're just defined instead of assigned membership, which right. would be the typical membership. They're dynamic based on that rule. So it could be sales, it could be marketing, it could be people in sales in a particular state. Yeah. You could do whatever you want with it.
That sounds like a perfect topic for the follow-up blog based on the show, if you're up.
Yes, yes, we'll definitely do that.
Awesome. Well, Dan Ray, my fellow Chicagoan, always great to see you. Thanks for joining us. And to hear more and to dig in a little bit deeper, check out the blog where Dan lists how you can join his YouTube, all the cool stuff that he's doing. He's got some amazing content, and we'll look forward to your blog as well. Thanks for joining us today, Dan.
Thanks, Stephen. Appreciate it.
All right, everybody, welcome back for our second segment on the show. I have one of my new favorite MVPs. Karoliina is joining me today. She is a three-time MVP. She joined us in our Ignite video, knocked it out of the park, said you have to come back, and she has chose to talk about Viva Insights, which is such a great topic because I get all the time, what is Viva and really how does it work? And the question I get a lot about Insights is it private? You know, are people able to spy on me and see all my information? And I know you're going to talk about how really your managers see all their employees as an aggregate, or the company sees people by organization, by sales, marketing, OU, or by manager, but they can't see individuals. So first of all, what is Viva Insights? And then tell us a little bit about the privacy, and then you have a demo for us. I'm excited to see it.
Yes, I'm super excited to be here. Because just like a bit background information, so I think that we all have been there since like this remote and hybrid work game to norm. Like I'm at the office, you are at home. All the employees have really struggled to stay connected to the teams, and employees are maybe feeling overworked under those like massive workloads. It's 7 p.m. in here, by the way. and employees, they work longer days. Like me, they sit in more meetings than ever before. They're producing content, more content than ever before. But still, like, despite all of these meetings, all of these materials, communication channels, still managers and leaders feel disconnected with their team members. And I think it was in the Work Trend Index study said that over half of the managers feel that leadership is actually out of touch with employees. And I think that's super, super scary.
I agree. It's interesting because our company used, our marketing org used Viva Insights and took a look and realized very early during the pandemic, we were doing, you know, 5 days worth of work in 4 days, that we had gone from hour-long meetings with breaks to 30-minute meetings back-to-back. And because of this, we added that functionality in Outlook where you can start and end meetings early. And they've given us Friday afternoons as no meeting Fridays. So we have from noon on, without any meetings, is that time to get caught up on everything so we can actually enjoy our weekend. So the Viva Insights tool is super powerful for that. And when it can create very actionable things to do, to what you were saying.
And I love it because it's based on data, like real data collected from M365, which is private. It is anonymous. And I see that many people are worried about Now, can my manager see if I'm joining all the meetings in time, or does my manager see all my personal information? And no, they can't. It's all like groupified at the team level or at the organizational level.
Right. It's all aggregate data. Absolutely. So let's take a look at a demo.
Cool. Yeah. Viva Insights is all about leading employee experience and well-being with data and actionable insights. It collects that user data all around N365, but it makes it anonymous. And it creates automatic reports based on how your team members communicate and collaborate. And I think Viva Insights is an amazing leadership tool. It's built to help managers to lead their teams better and to focus on that employee experience. I think it's about being able to lead based on facts and data, not that gut feeling. In Viva Insights, you'll find two sections that are especially relevant to managers: teamwork habits and organization trends. And you will see these sections if you are given a group manager access in Viva Insights. You will see all of these people according to the AD structure or by a separate data file. But you can also edit your own team by removing or adding relevant persons. One-on-one discussions with team members are an easy and human way to stay connected with your colleagues. I think they create trust and they give people an opportunity to open up in a safe environment. Actually, almost half of the leaders say that relationship building is one of the greatest challenges in remote and hybrid work, and simply having that chat goes a long way. One-on-ones, they can be a short chat during a coffee break or a longer meeting with specific agenda. And remember also to reserve time for that free discussion as well, because supporting employee experience and that work-life balance requires also this like personal touch. Viva Insights, it will also send you emails that tell you to reserve the precious one-on-one time with your team members. And you can schedule the slot with just a simple click. Okay, with the meeting insights, you can see how your team is performing in meetings. All the information, yet again, is on the team level. So I can't see any unique employee stats. These insights, managers could and should use improved teamwork and better meetings. For example, if you have lots of long meetings, is it relevant? You have to really know your team and how to interpret the results. For some teams, long meetings are normal, but for others, that's not the best way to work. Another interesting data point in here is that better people have joined in time in meetings. If people are always running late, it's maybe a sign of overlapping or even double booked meetings. But of course, we are humans and we need breaks in our day. Having a day filled with those back-to-back meetings might feel more productive, but actually studies show that it's the opposite. So, as a manager, help your team members to have those breaks. Could this meeting be 45 minutes instead of 60? Or could this meeting be just a message in Teams, after all? And sometimes, we also need to take a look in the mirror. Lots of times, it's us, team managers, who are actually responsible for their team burning some midnight oil. According to research, boss overtime accumulates to employee overtime. So living in this asynchronous hybrid world gives us actually the false feeling of having to be always on. So as a manager, you have the power to do better and to help your team members to try. Share that information about how to set your working hours and quiet time settings. No more those late night notifications. If you get a great idea during the weekend, maybe schedule your message to be sent on the Monday morning. And if your workday is looking like triple peak mountain, maybe try virtual commute. Viva Insights gives you suggestions to do the right thing. So maybe heed to the AI's advice. And the place to see all of those suggestions is organization threads. Yet again, I can see any individual information. It's all on team or organizational level. The data you can see here is chosen based on research. What kind of behavior at work advances or disturbs good collaboration and well-being? So remember that data itself is just information. With actionable insights, you can transform your data into knowledge and easily help your colleagues to work smarter today.
That was great. And one of the other things I also love about Viva Insights is when you haven't had enough time in your week to just get work done. One of the things is I love the multitasking. You're multitasking in meetings. That means you don't have enough time to get all the other things that you need to get done. Yeah. And it will say, hey, you have some open slots. Let's protect this time so that you can get that kind of work done. Has that helped you in sort of organizing your week? Big heart, yes.
Yes, that's amazing. And I really love that as a manager, you can also reserve those, for example, no meeting days to your team. You can read more about it in the blog. And focus time for yourself is maybe one of the most nice and most used features in Viva Insights alongside Praise.
I agree. It's awesome. So with that, Karoliina, of course, thanks so much for staying up late and joining us. And for everybody else, this is our last episode of season 6. We want to thank all of you for joining us, for sharing your episodes, telling me at conferences the things that have been impactful, which you'd love to see in the show. Your feedback and your continued support of the show means the world to us. From myself here in the United States, up in Seattle, from Karoliina in Finland, thank you so much for joining us. And we will see you. Have a great holiday. Have a great New Year's. And we will see you next season. So thanks so much.